Good morning, students. In today's class of retail management, we'll start with the new topic, that is importance of retail store locations and importance of and the types of retail store locations. So let us recap what we have studied in the previous classes. In the previous classes, we have studied what is retail location. We have also understood what are the various factors affecting the retail location site. If we just recollect what are the various, a lot of factors are there which are responsible or which affect or influence the retail store location. Let us just recollect what are the various factors. The first factor that is important in the factor that affects or influences the retail store location, is the selection of the area. Before, after the retailer decides upon the format or in which he will open the retail outlet, then he has to first decide the selection of the country, the region, then the selection of the area, the neighborhood area, the trading area where he wants to open the retail outlet. So this is one of the major factors affecting the retail store location. Second is the choice of the site. The choice of the site is also very important, because the choice of the site will just tell the retailer the exact position or the place where the retail outlet will be opened. The place or the retail site location should be decided in such a way that it should have proper visibility and proper communication network should be there. Roads and should properly connected with good parking areas, facility, and also good roads and transport services must also be there. So third condition that comes into most important factor that is responsible is the scale of operation. We have to decide the scale of operation of the business, of the retail business, of the retail outlet. We have to decide what is the amount of money we are going to invest in it, what is the amount of risk we are going to bear, and what is the potential of business, of the retail business. Keeping these things in mind, we will decide upon the scale of operation. Then comes the connectivity of ease of traffic flow. When we say connectivity, the place should be properly connected by various roads, railways, so that infrastructure is there, so that people can come and go from the particular retail location. And also there must be ease of traffic flow. The traffic, there should be proper parking facility, and the consumers should not feel cramped in the particular retail location site. So these are some of the factors that are very important. Apart from that, we have to also look at the cost effectiveness of the retail location. We have to see whether we are going to amount of capital or money we are going to invest in this. Either we are going to own the retail outlet completely, or we are going to lease the retail outlet. So the cost effectiveness also depends. Suppose we are deciding to open the retail location in a place which is has less visibility, but the retail outlet will be very cheap, or the rent of the retail outlet will be very cheap. Similarly, we may also decide whether to open in a retail outlet in a very high traffic commercial street where the visibility will be more. So we have to decide what is the cost effectiveness of the retail outlet, and we have to also see the potential of business in order to decide the whether the proper retail outlet that we are choosing is matches our cost effectiveness factor. Also, we have to look at the various presence of competitors in the particular area, whether our business will be a solitary standalone business or retail outlet, or will be in a particular business district, or will be part of a shopping mall, planned or unplanned shopping centers. So all these things has to be kept in mind while deciding, because the number of competitors also impact the market share and the amount of traffic or consumers visiting the particular district. So this is also one of the major factors that is impacting the retail store location. Then comes the source of supply. We have to decide from where we get the source of our supply of this raw material or merchandise, also the distribution, because these things has to be kept in mind, because this will reduce the transportation cost and bring about efficiency and effectiveness in the supply chain operations and management. So these things also have to be kept in mind while deciding the retail store location. Then comes the indexation of retail saturation. We see how much is the complexity of the retail locations there, how many retail locations are there. So this indexation will decide that whether I'll get proper business, proper visibility, or whether I can maintain a steady flow of income in the particular retail site. Then we have to decide upon the infrastructure available. When we say infrastructure, it means the whether there's proper in the shape of roads, in the shape of parking facility, in the shape of proper electricity, lighting, security services, all these things are properly aware of whether they're available in that particular retail location, because that will decide how far the infrastructure. Sometimes due to infrastructure, the retail site location, the cost of retail site location will be more. So these things is one of the major factors that has to be kept in mind while deciding upon the retail store location. Then comes the amount of capital that is we are going to invest, and how far that amount of capital we are able to invest in the particular business. That is also important facility. We have to see how much financial capability of ourselves should be kept in mind. Also, we have to see the parking facility. This is also one of the major factors that is affecting the retail site location, because if the parking facility is more, then the people will come and will park their vehicles and will be, spend more time in the retail outlet. Whereas if the parking facilities are not available properly, then they will not be interested to visit the store. Apart from that, there is a visibility of the store. If the store is highly visible, the amount of traffic it will attract will be more in comparison to a store which is not visible. So that is also one of the important factors. There are also other legal and regulatory factors, municipal laws, the laws of the particular area, the laws of the various rules and regulations of the landlord, the various rules of advertising and placing billboards in the particular area. So all these things should also be taken into the consideration. And finally, it is the personal factors of the should be also kept in mind, deciding that how far the shop is from the owners or the retail owner's house, whether the retail person or owner will be able to manage the retail site properly. So all these personal factors are also affecting this retail site location. Now we'll understand why this retail site location is very important. So we have to understand the importance of the retail store location. And after completion of these retail store locations, then we'll move to types of store locations. The first thing we have to understand is importance of location in retail business. So why this, there is a lot of discussion about the retail site location, why various factors are to be kept in mind, and why this is important, why this retail site is important from the retailer's point of view. That must be kept in mind. The first thing we have to see is that the retail store location is an important factor for the marketing team to consider while setting the retail marketing strategy. So it is one of the crucial important factors that the marketing team has to be must keep in mind while deciding the marketing, retail marketing strategy. So first, the retail marketer must understand the various factors impacting the retail site location. Then it has to design a marketing strategy, keeping the 4 P's in mind: product, price, place, promotion, and he will shape this particular retail marketing strategy. And while we, since this retail marketing strategy is of utmost importance to see that the business is profitable, the team has to consider the retail site location. So these are the major reasons why this retail location is important for the retail marketing strategy or retail marketing strategy person. First is that business location is a unique factor which the competitor cannot imitate. Hence, it can give a strong competitive advantage. Competitive advantage means something which is unique, which can do better than the competition, so that we will have an upper hand over the competition. So this business location is something, is it is a unique factor and which the competitors cannot imitate or copy. Because the reason is that once a particular retail site location is properly chosen and the retail outlet is open, it will have proper visibility, proper parking facilities, proper infrastructure, and it is abiding by all the rules and regulations, and it is matching the visibility is good. All these things, if are in place, are in tandem, then the amount of business that the retail site location will develop for the retail marketer, retailer, will be more. So this is something when the particular retail site location is already under a particular retailer, that is, that retail location site cannot be copied, or the same site cannot be used by any other retailer. So this gives a unique or strong competitive advantage to the retailer, and the no other competitors of the retailer can imitate or copy this, because this is a very unique factors available only to the particular retailer who has decided upon the retail site location after pondering or deciding upon the various factors of retail. Now, coming to the second point, selection of retail location is a long-term decision that requires long-term capital investment. It is important for the retail, setting the retail marketing strategy. This location is very important because retail location involves a very long-term decision for the retailer. He cannot change the retail location as per his own wish, as per his whim and fancy. So it is a long-term retail decision which requires a lot of capital investment that has to be made So proper importance or proper consideration should be given to this retail site location. Now coming to the third point, that is the good location is the key element for attracting customers to the outlet. So when the retail location is at a very proper place, at a very right place, then it will act as a key element, important element in attracting the customers to the outlet. The customers will be attracted to the outlet by looking at the visibility, there will be visibility of the store, and the people will be attracted to, the pedestrians will be attracted to come and shop from the particular retail outlet. So this is very important. So this retail location plays a very important role, because if a store is not visible, if the people are not able to understand the particular retail store location is not right and the retail store is not visible, then the retailer, then the customers will not be able to know where the retail location is, where the retail outlet is. They will not understand what is the merchandise that is sold in the retail outlet, is proper parking facilities is not there. Then also it will not be able to attract a lot of customers, because the customers will feel that when they come to purchase merchandise from the particular retail outlet, they will feel that they will not shop for longer periods of time. So these are the one of the disadvantages. So a proper good location with good parking facility, good infrastructure, good connectivity and good visibility will help a lot to attract the customers into the outlet. So it is very important. This location is very important in retail business. It is very essential for setting the retail marketing strategy. Another thing is that a well-located store makes supply and distribution easier. Because when the shop is very centrally located, it's located in a particular place from where the source of supply is very easily, merchandise can be got to the particular outlet, or the distribution can be very easily done. Then it will be very easier, because then the overall, there will be no chance for delay in getting the orders. And whenever there is a stock out, there will be products available. So the chances of the stock out in the particular retail outlet will be reduced a lot. So a well-located retail outlet ensures that the proper supply and distribution is there, and there is no stock out, and there is no problem in the availability of merchandise in the shop. So that is the reason why it is important, this location is important for setting the retail marketing strategy. Now coming to another point is that the transportation cost is reduced, and it reduces the overall cost of supply chain management and operations. Obviously, when the retail outlet is centrally located, is well located, and when it is located near the supply of raw supply of this merchandise, then the distribution and the transportation, supply and distribution cost will be reduced, the transportation cost will be reduced. So when the transportation cost is reduced, it will add to the profit of the retail outlet, and it will reduce the overall cost that the retailer has to spend towards this supply chain management and various operations related to it. So that is one of the reasons why this retail location should be well located, to see that the transportation cost is reduced and the cost to the retailer in maintaining the overall supply chain management and operations is considerably reduced. So this will act as a cost cutting factor. So this is very important for setting the retail marketing strategy. Then a well-placed retail store can also help to influence the buying habits of the customers. This is also very important, because if a retail store is properly located, proper visibility there, then the people will be visiting the store very frequently. They were whatever reasons they want to buy any merchandise, any type of merchandise they want, they will be visiting the store very frequently, because they know the place where the retail outlet is open. So it is very important that a well-placed retail outlet will help influence the habits of the consumers, of the customers, and they will be much more inclined to buy from the particular retail outlet. So these are the various importance of location in retail business, and that is, these are the reasons due to which this retail location is of utmost importance, and the retail marketer or the retailer should take consideration of or understand the importance of this location and take into consideration all the factors when deciding upon the retail marketing strategy. Okay, now coming to the various types of retail locations that are available for a retailer. Another point is that meeting the immediate demands of the consumer and fulfilling the urgent orders of the retail outlet will not be difficult. So this is also one of the factors, one of the importance of location as a factor, because the meeting of the immediate demands of the consumer can be fulfilled, and the fulfilling of the urgent orders of the retail outlet will be of no difficulty. There will be no difficulty in fulfilling the immediate demands and the urgent requirements or the orders of the customer. So these are the reasons why the location is very important for the retail point of view and for setting the retail marketing strategy. Now we'll understand the various types of store locations that are available for the retailer to choose from where he can decide that this is the type of retail store location I will select for opening my retail outlet. Okay, a store area is an area where the retailer attracts customers. So it is the place where the retailer is able to attract customer to the place. It is also known as the called as the catchment area, because it is the place from which he can get the traffic or catch the traffic that and attract them into the store. Because once the retail customers are attracted towards the store, they will make purchases. They will stay for longer periods of time. They will make purchases. So what is important is that the retailer should be able to attract these customers into this retail outlet, of his retail outlet. So there are three basic type of trade areas. So under the retail management, there are three basic type of trade areas. What are that? Freestanding or isolated store. When the shop is in a freestanding or isolated store, means it is the one of its kind store that is standing in a solitarily. So it is known as freestanding, isolated or solitary store. Now second type is part of a business district or center, or these are also known as unplanned shopping areas. So these areas of shopping were not developed immediately. They took time to develop and these were not properly planned, but they have become the part of this unplanned business district. They are also known as unplanned shopping areas. Third is the part of a shopping center or planned shopping centers. What happens in planned shopping centers? These are specially designed with the view of in a central places to attract customers into the store. So being a part of a shopping center allows the retailer to get a lot of customers into the store. So we'll understand all the three types of this store locations one by one. We'll start with the first thing, that is free standing or isolated store. This type of retail location is any standalone building where the any business any retailer opens his business outlet in a standalone place, then it is known as a freestanding or a isolated store. Where there are no outlets in the vicinity of the store, and therefore the store depends on its own pulling power and promotion to attract customers. This is very important to understand, because since there are no similar stores in the vicinity, there are no stores in the vicinity, therefore the store has to completely depend upon its own pulling power, its own brand in attracting consumer into the store, and they also the promotion activity that is ongoing in the particular retail outlet. So these are the things they have. The retail store has to attract its customers on its own merit. So they will not be having any catchment area. So it is beneficial for the, in some cases it is beneficial and some cases it's not beneficial. We understand the advantages and disadvantages later on. But the main thing is that there is no retail outlet in the vicinity, and therefore the store has to depend on its own merit in pulling the crowd or traffic into the shop and the promotion activities, whatever is continuing in the store, in order to attract customers into the store. This is the main reason we have to understand. Then these are positioned on roads or near other retailers or shopping centers. So the standalone buildings are not, they are generally positioned on roads or nearer to other retailers or shopping centers. So to have a proper visibility, that is the reason they are positioned in such a way. They are mainly used for food and non-food retailing or as convenience shop. So these are the things for the merchandise. These are generally opened. So maybe food or non-food or sometimes as convenience shops. Now, for example, if we take kiosks, mom and pop stores similar to Kirana stores in India. So these are small stores that are opening in US. So this kiosk or mom and pop stores or the Kirana stores are the examples of the various freestanding or isolated store. Now coming to that, this type of location has several advantages. When you are opening a freestanding or an isolated store, these are certain advantages attached to it. That is the reason people are interested in opening a particular freestanding or isolated or solitary store. First is that there is no competition whatsoever. So the competition, from competition point of view, there is no competition. So it is good for the retailer, because he has a complete market, untapped market from where he can get customers. This is one of the major advantages. Second is low rent. The cost of rent will be low, because since there are no other retail outlets in the vicinity, the landlord cannot charge a very commercial rate of rent from this retailer. So this is also reason why the low rent is one of the advantages. This is the reason which encourages people to open this freestanding or isolated store. Then third is less operation restrictions. the regulatory laws relating to operations of a particular retail outlet in this freestanding or isolated store will be less. Because since a lot of stores are not there, the parking facility, the advertising, all these things, they will be very, very easy. And another reason, as Arvind has already written, is easy parking. So parking is easily available. Whatever advertisement, other things that can be done in the particular area will be easier for the people. The restrictions, operation restrictions, local restrictions, municipal restrictions will be comparatively less in comparison to the other two type of store locations. So this is the reason why people are, especially retailers, are inclined towards opening this freestanding or isolated store. So these are the main four advantages that encourages them to open this freestanding, isolated or solitary stores. But with the advantages, there are certain disadvantages that are related. Let us come to the disadvantages. However, it is difficult to attract customers and advertising costs are high. Obviously, we have already discussed this, that the shop has to attract customers into the store based on their own pulling power, on their own merit. And the cost of advertisement will be also very much, because a lot of money will be wasted, or a lot of money will be used in attracting the attention of the customer, or to attract people into the customer. Promotional activities has to be done in order to explain the or make understand the customer that a particular shop is open in a freestanding or isolated store, and which is offering a very best quality of merchandise to the customers at very profitable and very economical rates. So it is very difficult to attract customers, and the advertising cost will be more, because here the shop will not be having any a big catchment area, and the people has to, the customers has to come to the shop based on the merit of the store. So if the store is very selling very value for money goods, or the merchandise of very good quality, it has a particular brand, then obviously people will be attracted, more customers will be attracted to the store. Whereas if it is not a big brand, or the cost of the merchandise is not very economical or value for money, then the chances of getting the customers will be less. However, the advantages, due to the various advantages of no competition, low rent, operational, no less operational restrictions, and easy parking, these are some of the main advantages which encourages retailer to open this kind of store locations. Now, the second type of store location that we're going to focus on is part of business district or centers or unplanned shopping areas. So these shopping areas were not planned, started as a planned way, but rather with the passage of time, they developed and became shopping centers, which are previously not planned. So these are retail locations that are evolved over time and have multiple outlets in close proximity. So these business district or centers, they have evolved over a particular period of time, and they have multiple stores. All different kinds of stores are open in nearby proximity or close proximity to one another. Second is that unplanned business centers or district is a place of commerce in the city which developed historically at the center of trade and commerce in the city or town. So these places were not particularly devised or planned with the aim of attracting customers. So these, with the passage of time, historically they developed because people understand that the particular areas, similar kind of shops are there. So if I go to the particular place, I can get the merchandise which I want to buy. So these shops or these unplanned business centers or districts were not planned, and they were historically developed depending upon the trade and commerce in the particular city or town in which the unplanned business or shopping area is. Third is, a business district can be of three types. It may be a central business district, it may be a secondary business district, or a neighboring business district. So this unplanned shopping areas can be again divided into three kinds: central, secondary, and neighborhood. We'll understand all the three one by one. So let us start with the first kind of unplanned shopping area, is central business district. What is a central business district? Central business district, also known as CBD. So a CBD is the main center of commerce and trade in the city. So this is the place where all trade and commerce happens, particularly in a city. Okay. And it is characterized by high land rates and intense development. Since this, it is the center of the trade and commerce, and historically it has evolved, and this place is consisting of various outlets, retail outlets in close proximity of one another, selling the products or merchandise to the customers. So obviously, with passage of time, the land rates has increased, and depending, by seeing that the land rates are increasing, by seeing that the amount of trade and commerce are increasing day by day in the particular area or particular business district or center, that area or business district developed very intensely in order to match the demand. So this particular unplanned shopping areas will be characterized by high land rates and intense development. Third is a CBD is the hub of retailing activities there in the city. So this is the central hub where all retail activity, main retail activities of the city takes place. So since it is a hub of retailing activity in the city, obviously people will be, customers will be flocking to this area, they will be visiting this area in order to buy products. And also there will be proper parking, because over the time, since the amount of persons, customers visiting the area has increased, so proper parking facilities will also be developed in a particular way, so to see that to cater to this particular crowd visiting the particular hub of a retailing activity. So this is one of the reasons. Since it is the hub, the chances of the cost of promotion will be less, because more people will be obviously attracted, because they consider this place as the hub of retailing activity. So whenever they require to buy a particular merchandise, they will be inclined to visit that particular central business district. CBD serves different sections of population. For example, we take some examples. Connaught Place in Delhi and Colaba in Mumbai or Commercial Street in Bangalore are some of the market cities. So these are the Connaught Place or Colaba or Commercial Street. These are present in Delhi, Mumbai or Bangalore. These are considered as CBD, and they are able to attract a lot of customers as they are the retailing hub in that particular cities. So this is the central business district. Now we'll move to the second kind of part of business district or unplanned shopping areas is secondary business district. So these are secondary to the central business district. These are composed of unplanned cluster of stores often located on a major intersection of city. Their customers are from large part of the society. So what happens, large part of the city. So at a particular junction or a particular intersection, a lot of shops are opened, because since it is intersection point, a lot of people will be crossing those intersection points in a day. So the amount of visibility will be more in those particular areas. But these are not the central business districts. So these are the secondary business districts. So these are also developed in an unplanned manner, in a cluster manner, where the stores are open in a cluster manner. But they're generally open in intersection points in the city, main intersection points in the city, because they will be distributed in a large city, large part of the city, because these are generally will help the customers in the visibility, because the customer will understand the particular shop is available in a particular intersection point or a particular main area. So then they will be passing through the particular intersection point throughout the city. So there will be visibility of the store, and more sales will be happening. Then comes the last kind of this unplanned shopping area is neighborhood business district. It is an unplanned shopping area that has developed to serve the needs of the customer. So these are developed to serve the particular needs of the customer in a particular area. So the particular neighborhood, these are specially developed in order to cater to the needs of the people. It is characterized by the presence of stores like stationery stores, medical stores, medical shops, etc. So small stationery stores, medical shops, etc. are open in order to cater to the demand of the customers who are present in the particular locality, and to see to provide the as per the needs of the customer in the particular locality. If we say if it is a very posh area, so the neighboring businesses will consist of retail shops having this. If you say the example of medical stationery shops, they will be having the stationery items of very branded things. Whereas when the particular retail shop is open in the business district, which is consisting of very lower middle class of people, so the kind of stationery available and the brands will be also accordingly changed. It will be of not branded, unbranded, and mostly of a cheaper quality. So as per the requirements of the particular neighborhood, the business district, the people of the needs of the consumers or customers in the particular neighboring area or neighborhood business district, the shops will open up or will be catering to the needs of the customers. So as per the needs of the customers, this unplanned shopping area develops so that Example will be small stationery shops and medical shops. The third kind of store location, we have read two kind of store location. Now the third kind of store location is planned shopping areas. Okay, these are part of a business district center or another. Okay, sorry. And why it is important? Let us also study the advantages and disadvantages of the second kind of form of location. First is the main advantages of this unplanned shopping area is that high pedestrian traffic during business hour, high residential traffic is there from the nearby transport hub is there. So these are the three major reasons why this unplanned shopping areas grow, become the retailing hub in the city. First is that since they are retailing hub, during business hour, the traffic will be very more. And since the it is properly connected and has developed historically over time, so intense development has happened over time, the high residential traffic will be there. So people will be flocking to this place in order to make purchases. And also transport hub will be nearby because obviously since the place has developed and become a retailing hub historically over a period of time, the transportation has also, or the infrastructure of the particular area must have also increased over a period of time. So these are the major advantages of the part of business district or unplanned shopping areas. And apart from that, what are the disadvantages? The disadvantage is that this will be high security is required. Since these are retailing hub, a proper security features will be there because a lot of thefts may happen because threat of shoplifting and poor parking facilities are some of the difficulties or disadvantages that are particular. Since it is the retailing activity and hub of retailing activity, so a lot of the stealing of these goods will be there, threat of shoplifting will be there. So proper security has to be measures has to be taken to see that the stores are properly well secured, the CCTV cameras has to be in place. But the another disadvantage is that there's also the poor parking facility. Since it has the center of the retailing hub of the city, all people will be visiting these areas regularly. So there will be a very tremendous difficulty in parking facilities. So this is also one of the disadvantages. So we have understood the two forms of store locations. First is an isolated store. Second is an unplanned shopping area. The third kind of form that we're going to read is the planned shopping area, part of a shopping center or planned shopping centers. So what happens here? These centers are developed in a planned way in order to attract customers. Let us understand. A shopping center has been defined by the International Council for Shopping Centers as a group of retail or other commercial establishment that is planned, developed, owned, and managed by a single property. So these are example of a mall, a big shopping center or a mall. So what is that when a big shopping center or mall, we say it is a group of retail and other commercial establishments. A lot of retail outlets and commercial establishments come together in a planned way that are developed, owned and managed by a single property. So the whole mall will be managed by a particular single as a single property, and there will be various retail outlets opening in the particular building, but these will be part of the shopping center or the mall. There are retail locations that are architecturally well developed to provide a number of outlets, preferably under a particular theme. So these shopping centers or mall, these are prepared architecturally well in a well-planned manner under a particular theme. These sites have large key retail brands, also known as anchor stores, as well as small stores to add diversity and elevate the customer's interest. So the two kinds of stores that are present in these shopping centers, planned shopping centers or mall, is that there will be very large anchor stores, retail brand stores, because these are the main anchor stores that will be attracting customers into the shop. So they will be considered anchoring stores, and apart from that, there will be also the small stores which will are also present in order to attract the attention of the consumers towards the particular area. So the basic configuration of a shopping center is a mall or a strip center. A mall is typically enclosed and climate controlled, a walkway is provided in front of the stores. So a mall is a generally a very closed, enclosed and climate controlled area where a walkway is provided for the people in front of the stores to view these stores from outside and also to get into the store. A strip center is a row of stores with parking provided in front of the stores. So these are, a strip center is considered a line of retail store. These are open adjacent to one another, and a parking facility is given in front of the stores. So it may be this planned shopping centers may be either a mall or a strip center. In India, we can categorize this planned shopping center into two categories. So these planned shopping centers again can be divided into two categories. Let us understand the categories. First is a regional shopping center or mall. So these are the maybe a mall or a regional shopping center. So these are the largest planned shopping centers. So when we are talking about this kind of shopping centers, these are very large shopping centers. Often they are anchored by two or more major department stores and have enclosed mall, serve as a large trading area and have high rents. The regional shopping centers or malls, they have few very big department stores which are act as anchor stores in order to attract a lot of customers into the store. And apart from this, they have this enclosed area, the very large trading area, and these shopping malls or shopping centers will be having very high rents because these are properly maintained in a planned way. They have proper parking facility and other features, so these will be having very high rental amounts to be given by the retailer in order to occupy these places. For example, Ansal Plaza, Spencer Plaza, Crossroads, DLF City in Gurgaon. So these are some of the examples of these regional shopping centers or malls. Now, coming to the second kind of planned shopping center is neighborhood or community centers. It is usually has a balanced mix of stores, including few grocery, chemist, and a variety store, and a few other stores selling convenience goods to the residents of the neighborhood. So these stores are small neighborhood or community centers which are specially designed to cater to the needs of this neighborhood area, and they consist of the small grocery stores, chemist stores, variety stores, or small this convenience selling goods stores. So these are formed or shaped in such a way in order to attract the residents of the neighborhood and also as per the needs of the neighborhood, residents of the neighborhood. So if we say what are the advantages and disadvantages of the planned shopping areas, we are not talking about regional shopping center or neighborhood or community center. We are talking about the whole thing, that is the planned shopping center or the part of shopping center. So major advantages of this kind of form of type of retail location will be high visibility will be there. It will be able to attract more customers. Visibility will be more, high customer traffic, and excellent parking facility. Since they are very properly planned as per the regulatory norms, municipal norms, other prevailing norms, and the rules and regulations, they will be having this proper excellent parking areas. These will be developed very properly. The customer traffic will be more because the customers know that if they visit the particular area, they will be able to get the requirements of their merchandise. So these are the main advantages why this planned shopping centers or malls or strip centers are very, very famous. Apart from that, there are certain disadvantages that has with it. First is high security is required and the cost of occupancy is high, because obviously the cost of occupancy is high because since it is high visibility and high customer traffic is already present, so the cost of occupancy cost will be very high. And also security cost will be high because since these are the main areas where a lot of customers come and visit to buy the merchandise, so proper security has to be maintained to see proper parking facilities there, cars are properly parked, bikes are properly parked, proper security is there in that area in order to monitor the crowd. So these are the disadvantages of the planned shopping centers or malls or strip centers. So now we have understood what are the various types of store locations. So in today's class, we have understood two topics. First is the importance of store locations, and second is the types of store locations present in a particular city. So please go through the notes. I will be sending, go through the note that I'll be sending digitally. Please go through the video. If you have any doubts, contact me. No need to panic. Prepare at home. And finally, thank you for your attention.